Philippine lawmakers, business groups, and analysts are divided over President Marcos Jr.'s second State of the Nation address. Some called the speech comprehensive, while others found it lacking. Jervis Manahan reports.
Senators have mixed reactions to the president's second State of the Nation address, which was 1 hour and 11 minutes long. Senator Grace Poe gave the president a high grade, but she clarifies the implementation of the programs is another matter.
Grado based ito sa content ng kanyang speech. Okay? Based sa content. Siyempre, iba naman ang grado later on sa implementation. Pero ngayon, kung ibabase ko sa kanyang speech, malumanay, maayos, komprehensibo, sasabihin ko, 97%.
Senator Joel Villanueva also says he is satisfied with the president's SONA. Minority senators, meanwhile, question some of the president's statements.
Kung tignan natin yung figure na binigay ng presidente sa employment rate natin, practically we have full employment. And 96% plus, that is practically full employment. And I do not believe it because I could see unemployment all around.
Some business leaders found the speech comprehensive and impressive.
I didn't know that there were so many roads and so many bridges that were being built or had been built. Huh? Mm. So I didn't know the numbers. But hearing the numbers, it's still impressive.
We are very positive, about the prospects of the president painting a bright future for the country. And of course, the only thing that we can do is really to support that and also be mindful be alert in terms of monitoring those achievements or accomplishments, in making sure that whatever is being promised in terms of key development areas would also be realized based on the timeline set.
For agriculture group Sinag, the marching order of the president, at least for their sector, is clear and that it should be quickly put into action. However, some analysts found the speech lacking.
Tinalakay niya from water to education to the military pension fund, the Maldika investment fund. So medyo comprehensive. Ang kulang lang is yung hinahanap ko, yung medyo yung storya, yung heart-tugging phrases, yung inspirational talk, yung call to action, yun ang medyo kulang lang.
Parang we're all winners, there are no losers. That's, diba? That's what. But at the same time, it didn't feel really inspiring because you just know that that's not the case.
Post-SONA discussions from various agencies will be held on Tuesday to further elaborate the pronouncements of the president. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
The state of the nation is sound and improving. That's how Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. summed up his second State of the Nation address, touting his administration's accomplishments in its first year. Jackie Pascual gives us the highlights of the president's report.
The economy, agriculture, health, education, and infrastructure. These are some of the key highlights of the second State of the Nation address of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The chief executive admits the biggest problem of his administration is inflation. But he says efforts to curb rising commodity prices are on the right track. The consumer price index last month cooled to 5.4% after peaking at 8.7% in January.
In spite of all the difficulties, we are transforming the economy. We are stabilizing the prices of all critical commodities.
The chief executive, who is also the secretary of the Agriculture Department, touted his Kadiwa program, which he plans to expand to more areas. Marcos also issued a stern warning to smugglers and hoarders who have been blamed for the rising prices of agricultural products.
Taas ng presyo ay ang mga smuggler, mga hoarder, at mga nagmamanipula ng presyo ng produktong agrikultural. Hinahabol at ihaabla natin sila ang kanilang ginagawa. Napapahamak hindi lamang ang mga magsasaka, kundi tayo rin mga mamimiling. Bilang na ang mga araw ng mga smuggler at hoarder na yan.
The President also urged Congress to create the Department of Water Resource Management. Water conservation and building buffer stock are crucial due to the looming impact of El Nino.
Ang tubig ay kasing halaga rin ng pagkain. Kailangan natin tiyakin na may sapat at malinis na tubig para sa lahat at sa mga susunod na salinlahi.
Meanwhile, Marcos championed the 194 flagship infrastructure projects worth 8.3 trillion pesos under the Build Better More program. Mostly are transport projects. And one way to help fund these projects, he says, is through the Maharlika Investment Fund. Marcos also made many other promises, like the electrification of all homes by the end of his term, recalibrating the K-10 curriculum to be at par with international standards, digitizing government services, and releasing the delayed COVID-19 health emergency allowance to health workers.
Upang masuklian naman natin ang naging sakripisyo ng ating mga health workers sa pribado at pampubliko ng mga ospital nung nakaraang pandemya, ipapamahagi na sa kanila ang kanilang COVID health emergency allowance at iba pang mga nabimbing benepisyo.
The President also spoke about boosting the recovery of war-torn Marawi, granting amnesty for rebel returnees, and the anti-drug campaign.
Campaign against illegal drugs continues, but it has taken on a new face. It is now geared towards community-based treatment, rehabilitation, education, and reintegration.
Marcos adds he will be accepting the resignations of rogue cops involved in the drug trade. Last January, Interior Secretary Benjamin Abalos called for the courtesy resignation of top policemen as part of an internal cleansing program.
Unscrupulous law enforcers and others involved in the highly nefarious drug trade have been exposed. I will be accepting their resignations. In their stead, we will install individuals with unquestionable integrity who will be effective and trustworthy in handling the task of eliminating this dreaded and corrosive social curse. We cannot tolerate corruption or incompetence in government.
In his last sona, the President said the state of the nation is sound. This year, he says, it is improving. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Now, the State of the Nation address is not just a political exercise, it's also a red carpet event. Ganiel Krishnan gives us a look at who the most powerful and influential were in this report.
The State of the Nation address has always been one of the most anticipated fashion events in the country, as people get to see different takes on the Barong Tagalog and the Filipiniana. Many politicians opted to wear their Filipiniana in white, like Senator Nancy Binay, Congresswoman Len Alonte, Congresswoman Stella Kimbo, as well as former President and Pampanga's 2nd District Representative Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Actress Heart Evangelista, the wife of Senator Francis Escudero, stunned in her all-white modern terno jumpsuit.
I'm wearing Michael Leyva. Just wanted it to be very, you know, subtle and just very simple and elegant.
One of the standouts in the red carpet was Senator Aimee Marcos, who wore a Kalinga Apayao traditional dress. She said she is paying homage to the vanishing culture of the Cordilleras.
Kalinga, Apayao, and the entire Cordillera. We have to remember the vanishing cultures of the original Filipino. Ito itsura ng katutubong Filipino bago tayo sakupin ng iba't ibang mga dayuhan.
Senator Riza Hontiveros meanwhile donned a modern barot saya. Her dress was made by Lumban weavers.
Ito po ay inspired ng Filipino weaving traditions. So, pinya na hinabi sa aklan, binurda sa Lumban, and then yung strips ng pinya, hinabi para maging banig. Ganon din yung bagop, banig.
Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel wore a hand-painted barong by a student. It is inspired by the anti-imperialist nationalism of revolutionary hero Andres Bonifacio. It is also a jab at the administration's plan to revive mandatory ROTC. Senator Robin Padilla's traditional barong had a twist. Inside his barong is a silhouette of Andres Bonifacio. Meanwhile, Senator Lauren Legarda espoused sustainability as she walked the red carpet in her 30-year-old Filipiniana made by designer Patis Tesoro.
pati si Tesoro, in my first term in the Senate, in the early 1990s, ito'y suot ko na. Pinapatunay ko na hindi kailangan ng bago para maging magara o maganda, di ba? Na syempre, sapatos ko galing Marikina. At ang bag ko gawa ng isang batang babaeng designer. So puro babae na bata. Pero hindi mga bago, mga luma. Kaya bagong senado, lumang suot.
Vice President Sara Duterte once again honored Mindanao's rich culture and tradition by wearing a traditional Maguindanaoan dress to celebrate the Moro tribe, while First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos came in a full-on chartreuse Filipiniana. Gino Krishnan, ABS-CBN News.